Republicans and Democrats share a political weapon. It's called gerrymandering. It's the process of drawing voting districts unfairly in favor of one's political party. Even though redrawing districts happens every 10 years, gerrymandering is difficult to prevent or even identify. But thanks to mathematical tools that are powered by crowdsourced data and public software, voters can now keep tabs on the process.
The redistricting process could be even more chaotic this year, which will leave more room for partisan gerrymandering. And at least one study found that one in two states have an extreme risk of gerrymandering. This year, states are having to deal with delayed census data and having to move some of their deadlines. We won't see that full data until later into the year, likely by September 30th. It's also the first time that some protections in federal law won't be in place to protect against federal gerrymandering because of Supreme Court cases.
As redistricting battles ramp up, third-party groups have been working on a new way to get involved in the process.
Math can be used to eliminate bugs in democracy in several ways. Math can help us diagnose when the rules have gotten out of whack or started generating out of whack results. But no reform can possibly take root without either a system to implement those or without citizens becoming engaged.
Sam's team is one of several groups developing public software that analyzes district maps. It generates rapid feedback from complex data for anyone looking for irregularities in their district.
Let's say that you're a citizen and you want to know whether a map is fairly drawn or not. You could download what's called a shapefile, which is all the shapes of the draft map, drop it into a calculator, and then gives you a scorecard. It's like a dashboard. This dashboard will then help people understand, well, this is not very fair to the parties, or, oh gosh, these shapes look pretty compact, or those county lines got split up. Simple mathematical formulas to detect when a plan has favored one party too much or another, or perhaps has frozen out a whole racial group or a community. And so those kinds of quantitative metrics can help people evaluate a map. So for instance, here in New Jersey, there was a reform that was floated that was ostensibly going to create more opportunities and more competition. And we dug into it and we discovered that that reform sounded pretty good on paper, but actually turned out to in fact entrench the majority, which in New Jersey is the Democrats. And so it looked to us like that was a problem. And citizen groups got hold of it. They pitched a pretty passionate argument that it was a bad reform and the reform did not succeed.
When most people think about redistricting, they think about the federal level. They think about how many seats in the U.S. House of Representatives each state is going to get. But there are also local implications, like where your school districts are and who your local leaders are going to be. So redistricting and gerrymandering matter at the federal, state, and local level.